Welcome back to Matt's Basement Workshop. Sponsored by SawStop, North America's number one cabinet saw. For more information, visit sawstop.com. By Highland Woodworking, find tools delivered to your door since 1978. Visit their website at highlandwoodworking.com. By Lee Valley and Veritas, with over 5,000 high-quality woodworking hand tools, visit their online catalog at leevalley.com. And by Centipede Tool, a revolution in sawhorse evolution. Visit their website at centipedetool.com. Hey everybody, welcome back to Matt's Basement Workshop. If you couldn't tell by the beginning of today's video, it is summer around here and I am daydreaming about laying in a hammock, maybe having a few cold drinks, just like my good friend Terry was when I shot that video. And as you can see, today's project was actually right there on the tabletop. We're building this neat little wooden six-pack, wooden drink carrier, whatever you want to call it. It's not just meant for beer, it's meant for whatever you happen to have on hand. Maybe some nice grape soda or something. We'll talk a little bit more about the design, not in today's episode, but we'll talk about it in the next one, because we're going to break this up into two episodes today. We'll cover the milling process and then the actual joinery. By milling process, I already have this milled down. With it being summer, that also happens to be wedding box season. So I have some scraps, some leftovers of this quarter inch, 5/16 inch material. This happens to be some pine. You could use whatever you have. In fact, it'd be kind of neat to have multiple different species or something on this. Just make it a really unique, fun little project kind of a thing. It doesn't take up a lot of wood. It's a great use for your scraps. In fact, this stuff often would usually end up just being like some sort of fire starter for when we're out at the fire pit. But it is definitely, I'm really proud of it. In fact, from the way it looks, a lot of our friends that saw these were kind of thinking, this would be a fun thing for you to make for me. So I guess over the summer, I might be making a few more of these. But the first thing we need to do is we need to actually start cutting our pieces. And like I said, today's episode is all about the milling and then some of the joinery work. So we're going to start out here at the table saw, and I begin by squaring up the piece that I'm working with, and then let's go ahead and jump right in to what we do next. Now that I cleaned up this first edge, what I'm going to do is measure over 5 3/8 from this edge, because I know it's exactly lining right up with the blade. We'll mark that on the fence, thereabouts. It's okay if it's a little off. And then now we're going to set up a stop block so that we can make two perfectly sized ends. So we got that in place. Let's go ahead and clamp this. And double check it. Okay. There. That's good. And then now what we'll do is just simply run the pieces. We'll do one, and then I'll be able to move it over and do the second one. Now the next thing we want to make is the middle divider, and we're going to do that by moving the stop block over to 8 3/16, and that will give us enough room for all of our standardized bottle sizes. So 8 3/16, put our stop block in place, get it lined up, there we go, and we're now ready. Now the next step is I want to cut a groove right down the center of these ends, and the purpose for that is that the divider will fit right into it. It's just going to be a very shallow groove, and it's just going to help to reinforce with the glue, and then also I'm going to put in some nice little brass tacks just to kind of, because I can. They really won't do a lot to hold it in place, but the glue, this way it gives it that much more surface space. And the way we're going to do this groove is we have our table saw set up, we have the fence pushed over so that it's just off center. In fact, what it is the blade is 1/8 of an inch wide. The material that we're gonna be cutting the groove for is approximately 1/4 of an inch. So I found the center, I offset the blade just a little bit to the side of it. When I run it through on one side, I'll bring it back, flip it over, I'll register against the other edge, and that should remove exactly the right amount of material in the middle here for the nice snug fit that we'll get with the divider. If it's still a little tight, we'll just simply readjust the fence and we'll be able to get the fit that we want from it. So let's get started. So here's that groove, and as you can see in the middle here, I got a little bit of some material that I just have to kind of knock out. In fact, actually, before I started filming, I started knocking these things out of the way with just my finger, come back in with a chisel, and we'll be able to clean that up. And the fit is just a little loose, but that's not so bad, because I think because of the fact that we're going to be using some polyurethane glue, it will actually expand a little bit, so I'm not too concerned about it. I think between that and then the brass fasteners that we're going to put in place, just the brass nails, it's going to give us a really snug fit. So far so good. Let's go ahead and repeat it on this one and we'll move on to the next step. Perfect tool for cleaning out some of this is this little router plane. You can get right in here, give it a good level cleaning with very little effort. There, that's almost there. In fact, let's drop it down just a pinch. Boop. There. That takes off that middle divot. And then I can repeat it on this one, just so that we're all at the same level. Perfect. Now the next step is to cut the side slats to length. And I'm gonna start by squaring up one end first. Then I'll measure for the location of the stop lock. Clamp it in place. Then I'll repeat the cutting action until all six slats are cut. Now there are a couple of short pieces that are going to be used as lateral dividers, and we're going to see more about these in just a second. So this is the middle divider, and I now want to cut little joints in here so that I can have these just slide right in. These are the lateral dividers. These are what are actually going to divide whatever bottles I have in here. Now you can see I went ahead and I've already cut this first one. I just need to remove the material, but I want to do this second one. And the way I'm going to do this is to make sure that I'm getting right into my line. I'm just going to take my chisel and just very gently start marking the line. So I'll just set it just in front of the line, just using some basic hand pressure. I'm going to push down, and then I'm going to create a little V-groove that will allow my saw just to kind of drop into that notch. And then this way, I've got it starting without it really skipping all over the place. Now, sometimes this works really good, and other times, there we go. And I'm going to use a nice cross-cut saw. So I'm going to grab my carcass saw here, and we'll just throw a little wax on. And very carefully, I'm going to try and hold this piece here, support it, and start the cut very slowly so that the wood doesn't split down here. There we go. And I'm just going to try and follow that line. No big deal if it wavers, preferably inward, because I'm going to come back in with my chisel and I can clean up the line itself. We still have to put a corresponding cut into there. So let's go ahead and let's finish this up. Drop it down to, I don't know if you can see in there, but I got a little mark to indicate how deep I want it. Now this one's a little bit more difficult because this scrap is ready to go. I could probably just come in with a chisel and remove it, but I'm not going to. In fact, you know what? Oh, well, that's no problem. That's on the bottom. There we go. Starting to get it. There. I have put too much wax on that blade. All right, we're almost to the bottom. Okay. Go ahead and remove this from the vise. And we can see that we now can just come back in with a chisel, and if everything is done right, we can pare that out. So let's do that next. One thing I discovered as I was taking this out, I don't know if you can kind of see that, it's got a little bit of a break in this piece already, and this is kind of an important piece. This is going to be the holder and the center divider. So what I'll end up doing is once I get all this stuff done, I'm just going to finish breaking this and we'll re-glue it, and it will actually make it considerably stronger. But in the meantime, let's go ahead, clamp this in position, grab a little bit thinner chisel here, and let's go ahead and knock out that material. Again, we're just using hand pressure here, and I will sneak up onto my lines. This is where having a nice sharp chisel really makes a huge difference. All right, yeah, that's pretty good. Now, let's just take this piece, and we'll have to end up removing some of the material here. So I'm gonna pull the camera around, get a better angle, and we'll just pare some of that away. So you can kind of see where my line is there, and I'm just gonna come in with my biggest chisel, and we'll try and set that up very carefully. Push downward pressure, not using a mallet, we're just using our hands. And we'll go ahead and just do a test fit. Alright, it's a little snug. I don't want it too snug because I don't want it to split. So let's just take, yet again, just a little bit more. This time we'll do this side. And we'll sneak up to that perfect fit. There. Let's clean out this end. Alright, that should do it. And it does. Excellent. All right, folks, that's a pretty good place to stop for today's episode. When we come back in the next one, we'll be shaping this nice little handle here. We'll be starting the assembly process, and you'll be able to build your own one. In fact, we'll talk a little bit about the design itself, because there's a few things that we could vary in here so that we could get a whole bunch of different bottle sizes in here and maybe another idea, but I'm going to share that in the next episode. Comments, questions, suggestions, you know how to get a hold of me. mattsbasementworkshop@gmail.com is the email. You can stop by the website, leave a comment in the show notes. In fact, I love it when you do that. I love to get that feedback going. And the same thing with YouTube. You can leave a comment over there if that happens to be where you're watching this. So until the next episode, again, where we will finish this up, I will be talking to you soon. Straight grains and sharp blades. Take care, everybody.
Thanks for watching. To find even more videos and woodworking-related content, be sure to visit our website at mattsbasementworkshop.com. You can also find us on Facebook, Twitter, and Google+. And don't forget to subscribe to the show either on YouTube, in iTunes, or you can even receive email notifications whenever we post something new.